Hello mortals. In order to describe an event, you need its spatial and time coordinates. Remove one of them and the event doesn't really make sense. That's exactly what we are going to talk about today. The universe before time itself appeared. Great thanks to NordVPN for sponsoring this video. So what happened before time existed? Now, common logic forbids such stupid questions, because you can't define a before without time. But would we get anywhere without asking stupid questions? That's why we will start with a totally different cosmological model. The CCC, or Conformal Cyclic Cosmology. It is a new perspective on the history of the universe proposed by the Nobel laureate, mathematician Roger Penrose. As the name suggests, this idea consists of a continuous succession of universes coming into existence after the death of their predecessor. But don't confuse it with the Big Bounce theory, the differences of which we will talk about later. The lifetime of such a universe is called an eon, which supposedly would have a duration of several Google years, that's a 1. With 100 zeros. Or two entire cyberpunk development cycles. Let's start with a dive into the deep past, the Big Bang. This video covers the topic regarding the very first seconds of the universe in the context of the theory of inflation, which is the most common model of describing what happened at the beginning. Briefly, this theory proposes an extremely rapid expansion of space, moments after the Big Bang. Before this expansion, the universe was so extremely dense and hot, that the Higgs field, the one that gives particles their masses, just refused to work under such extreme circumstances. Thus, everything in the universe was absolutely massless. And what's special about anything that doesn't have mass, is that it cannot experience time at all. Take the photon, for example. It is the particle that makes up light. And it doesn't have mass. If we take one which is traveling from the Sun to Earth, in order to be absorbed by your retina, from your mortal perspective, it would take the photon 8 minutes to complete its journey. But from the photon's perspective, well, the moment it was emitted is the very same moment it was absorbed. No time has passed. Because light is massless, it can travel at the maximum allowed speed of the universe, the speed of light, and this makes an eternity and an instant feel the same. So, to summarize, in the beginning we have a very hot and dense place with massless somethings everywhere and no time. Now, let's jump into the future. I think we landed into an Orwellian dystopia. Everything is censored, we are being watched and lots of services are blocked. How lucky are we to have brought NordVPN with us? Awarded as the best VPN of 2020. NordVPN encrypts your data while you browse online, and doesn't allow the bad guys to access it. Connect to over 5,500 fast servers anywhere in the world and surf anonymously from that region. Did YouTube block a video for your area? Or is there a Netflix show unavailable in your country? Simply select your region of choice and the problem is solved. You can even have your own dedicated IP. Choose double VPN for extra security or a peer-to-peer server for fast torrenting. Connect up to 6 devices at the same time and use it as much as you need it, as you are provided with unlimited bandwidth. The CyberSec suite available also acts as an ad blocker. Use the lightweight Chrome extension for even user-friendlier browsing. NordVPN is compatible with almost all operating systems, be it Windows, macOS, Android or iOS. Recommended by the top technology experts, you can get 68% off of your NordVPN subscription, paying only $3.15 per month. By accessing the link from the description and using the coupon Sciencephile, you also get 4 entire extra months for free. Now, let's go into the future. Right now, the universe is experiencing an accelerating expansion. That doesn't mean that universe grows into something outside it. There is no outside. As the universe is infinite. The space itself is stretching. Imagine space as an infinite grid of lines. Over the time, the distance between these lines will exponentially get bigger and bigger. With this expansion, the cosmos will become colder as its density decreases. After 100 trillion years, the last star will form. After 100 quintillion years, what is left of the dead stars either falls into black holes or mindlessly floats through the empty space. After 10 to the power of 40 years, black holes will be the only things remaining with mass. And mass is very important for the cyclic cosmology model. As we know, from the famous Einstein's formula, E equals mc squared, or m equals e over c squared. That means, mass is equivalent to energy. Moreover, the Planck equation E equals h time frequency, where h is the constant of Planck, says that energy and frequency are equivalent. Combine those two equations, and you obtain the equivalence between mass and frequency. So, anything with mass also has a frequency. And frequency is a very cool property to have, because, putting it simply, anything with a frequency acts like a clock measuring time, and a ruler measuring space. So as long as we have mass for measuring, we can keep track of the scale of the space-time, or the distance between the lines of the grid. But everything beautiful comes to an inevitable end. Remember when I said the black holes will be the only things remaining in the universe? Sadly, these giant fellas will evaporate through Hawking radiation, a process that takes an absurd amount of time. One with a mass of 10 billion suns would take 10 to the power of 64 years to evaporate completely, and for even more supermassive black holes, it would take several Google's years to radiate completely. And that's the number I used to describe the lifespan of an eon, because with the evaporation of black holes, mass just ceases to exist. And without mass, you can't keep track of the scale of the universe, because you are left with no tools to measure it. Under these conditions, measurements don't make sense anymore. So, in the end we are left with a vast sea of pure energy drifting through an undefined space-time grid. And the conditions at the end of the universe now match those at its very beginning. Mass may start forming once again from energy, which will trigger the space-time to expand and boom, you have a new Big Bang starting the next eon, and thus, continuing the cycle. This model, however, comes with a few problems. First of all, it supposes that electrons will eventually decay in the distant future, and they will be the only carriers of mass beside black holes. Also, that jump between eons would result in a loss of information and the violation of the laws of thermodynamics, both being crucial for the modern standards of physics. Because of these flaws, this model is not the most popular in the cosmological community. Even its own author called it outrageous when he first published it. But so were considered quantum mechanics and general relativity upon their discovery, two important theories for modern physics. In the end, the idea of a universe that appears and disappears in an infinite cycle may even turn out to be completely wrong. But a new and bold perspective on what could have happened before the Big Bang would surely encourage new ways of thinking and assist in further discoveries.